Hello friends, in the present video, we will discuss about the Skempton's method. And Skempton has proposed a simplified expression for the net ultimate bearing capacity for a saturated glaze. Okay, that means, let me write down that he has proposed equation for net ultimate bearing capacity for saturated glaze. Under undrained condition only. That means, according to Skempton's, directly we will get a value of net ultimate bearing capacity for which type of soils? For which is applicable only for the clays. It is not applicable for any gravelly soils. Always remember, if it is a Skempton's method, it will be applicable only for the clays, that is phi equal to 0. And those are applicable only for the undrained condition. So according to Skempton's, net ultimate bearing capacity will be nothing but a Cu into Nc. Already we know what is Qnu, net ultimate bearing capacity. What is mean by Cu? This will be nothing but a undrained cohesion. And coming to the NC, as we have discussed in the previous case, this is some factor. According to Skempton's, it is depending on the depth of the foundation to the width ratio. Understood? So only you have to remember that your Skempton method is applicable for the pure clays and for the undrained cohesion, and net ultimate bearing capacity is nothing but a Cu into NC. Cu will be given in the question, and NC for different types of footing, and depending upon the depth to the width ratio, you have to find out those values. Okay. Now let us see all those one by one. Okay. Now let us say case one. That is, suppose if your PF divided by B, that will be equal to zero. That means which case we are talking about? That means we are talking about, when this case is possible, when your depth of the foundation is equal to zero, that means where is your footing? Your footing is at the ground level. If your footing is at the ground level, then according to the Skempton's, your NC value will be 5 if it is a strip or continuous footing. These values we have to by heart it, they won't give in the exam. So if your footing is at the ground level, NC value will be 5 for strip or continuous footing, and it will be equal to 6 for remaining type of footing. What are the remaining types? Either it may be a square, or whether it may be a rectangle, or whether it may be a circular, or whether it may be a raft, doesn't matter. Except the continuous footing, whatever the footing you will take, if your footing is at the ground level, the NC value will be equal to 6. Okay, this is what about if your footing is at the ground level. Okay, there is no need of explanation how those values are coming. Those are proposed by the Skempton's by the practical observation. We have to by heart it for the exam. Now coming to the case 2, when your ratio 0 less than DF by B less than 2.5. Okay, if your DF by B, if it is in between 0 to 2.5, then your NC value will be equal to 5.0 into 1 plus 0.2 into DF divided by B. This is for strip or continuous footing. Suppose if you keep DF by B equal to 0, how much will you get? 5. So in the previous case, that is for the strip or continuous footing. Now that will be equal to 6.0 into 1 plus 0.2 df divided by b. If it is a square or circular, if it is a square or circular footing, always remember, for square or circular footing it will be 6 into 1 plus 0.2 into df by b. That will be equal to 5 into 1 plus 0.2 b divided by l into, and again into, 1 plus 0.2 df divided by b. This is if it is a rectangular footing. So rectangular footing will be equal to square when b by l is equal to 1. Suppose let us say b by l equal to 1, how much it will be? 1.2. 1.2 into 5 is how much? Obviously 6. This remaining term is same. Okay. So if your df by b, if in between 0 to 2.5, these are the values for the strip footing, square footing, and also values for the rectangular footing. Okay. And also next, see one more case, case 3. In case 3, if your df by b is greater than 2.5, that means df by b, it will be, it can be any value, 100, 200, 75, doesn't matter. Then your value of NC will be equal to 7.5 for strip or continuous footing and that will be equal to 9 for the remaining footings. What are the remaining footings? Whether it may be a square or whether it may be a circular or whether it may be a rectangle or whether it may be a raft, doesn't matter. I think remembering values are very easy, isn't it? For case 1, if your footing is at ground level, what are the values? 5, 1, 6. Similarly, if your df by b is greater than 2.5, again it will be 7.5, 9.5. only the thing is, if your df by b, if it is less than 0 to 2.5, we have to by heart these values. Now here we have to remember one point, that is if you recall the Terjaghi equation, Terjaghi equation is applicable only for the shallow foundation when your df is less than b. But here if you observe it, even if your depth of the foundation, if it is greater than the width also, we have written the values. That means Terjaghi's method is only applicable for the shallow foundations. But if you are talking about the Skempton's method, it is applicable for both shallow and deep foundation. This may ask for the one mark question in the exam. So Skempton's method, it can be applicable for shallow and deep foundation, but Terjaghi is only applicable for the shallow foundation. But what is the disadvantage here? This is only applicable for the undrained clays, Skempton's method. But if it is a Terjaghi, that can be applicable for sand and also can be applicable for the clays. So every method is having their own advantages and disadvantages. So you have to remember all of them for the examination point of view. Okay. So thank you. In the next problem, we will solve some problems based on the Skempton's method. Thank you.